Hi, welcome to our channel, Cela Cigars.
Behind the scenes.
In this channel, we're gonna be speaking about a Cuban cigar roller process in the factories in Cuba, and also a little about our brands.
And a little about Cuban culture as well.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Remember, in the description of this video, we're gonna give you the links so you can go in our website and get more information about us. Also, my name is William and she is my wife.
Hi, I'm Shakira.
Yeah, we're gonna be with you one time in the week. So, subscribe in our channel and expect new information about cigars. We're going to speak today about filler. Long filler versus short filler. We're going to describe the different kind of the cigars in Cuba, in my country. So you know, I don't speak English well, but I try. Yeah, I'm going to make a little demonstration about how to make a filler. I'm going to explain to you. My wife is going to speak with you also about.
So I'm going to be talking a little bit about where tobacco is actually grown, as well as just the anatomy of a cigar as a whole, and then he's going to talk about the filler specifically.
Okay.
Before we get into talking about short filler versus long filler, let's just generally talk about where tobacco is grown in Cuba. So Cuba is shaped kind of like this, right? It's kind of long. There are five regions in Cuba that tobacco is grown. There's Pino del Rio, which is in the west. Then there is Partido, which is in the southwest. There is Remedios, which is in the central. And then you have Vuelta Arriba, which is central and a little east. And then you have Oriente, that is in the east. And so what generally speaking people know is Pina del Rio, and that is probably the more famous area. And if you've ever visited Cuba, and most people come in through Havana, you take maybe a day trip, and we've done this quite frequently.
Yeah,
and
we was in Viñales. Yeah,
we brought family out to Viñales, which is in Pina del Rio, and that is in the Vuelta Abajo. Pina del Rio. So this is also going to be a Spanish language, English.
Spanish language, English language.
All of it, right? No. As he teaches me. So one of the things people ask all the time is like, why are Cuban cigars so much better than other cigars? And part of it is because of these regions. Part of it is because of the actual land that the tobacco is grown in. So like in Pina del Rio, you have this beautiful like red earth that is filled with nutrients and it's just gorgeous. And all of that gets kind of put into the leaf. And so that is one of the reasons that the tobacco that is grown in Cuba is like distinct, right? And different and kind of better than tobacco grown in other regions. So that's just a quick overview of the regions of tobacco growing in Cuba. We're gonna put a link in the description box so that you can see the map and provide a little bit more information. Okay, so let me get into a little bit the three parts of a cigar. So there are three pieces, the capa or the wrapper. And so that is the really pretty leaf that's on the outside. You see it, it usually doesn't have any veins on it. It's really, really smooth. There is the capote, and that's inside underneath the wrapper. This is a leaf that can be similar to the wrapper in terms of quality, but usually it'll have blemishes. It might be a bit thicker, and it's called the binder because it binds the filler together. And the filler, or the fortaleza.
Yeah, it's the fortaleza. It's the strength of the cigar.
That is
the level of the strength in the cigar.
That is the filler, and what's inside the cigar is the fortaleza. Mm-hmm. So it's the three parts. I'm gonna repeat it. The capa, or the wrapper, the capote, or the binder, and the fortaleza, or the filler. And there are two types of fillers, long fillers and short fillers. And I'm gonna turn it over to William to really get into what the deal is with fillers.
Okay, all right. That is good. So let's go to make some cigars.
Okay, we're here. Now I'm going to make a little demonstration how cigars roller in Cuba made the filler. We use, first I'm going to show you this leaf. This leaf, we call it capote. We use this leaf to roll a filler inside. We prepare the leaf. And now we are ready to start. Long filler versus short filler. What is the difference? Well, long fillers are made with a whole leaf. And short filler, we made it with the rest, the pieces of the tobacco leaf. When we smoke long filler, we can get more time because burning slowly. When you have a cigar made with short filler, the cigar is burning so fast. So a lot of people prefer long filler so they have more time enjoy the cigar. So here we have the three leaves we use to make filler. Seco, ligero, and volado. All that three leaves have different qualities. We're going to speak about that in another session. We're going to start now to make the long filler. We put the leaf together. This leaf, volado leaf, we put it all the time in the middle of your cigars. That is so important.
Hey William, why is it so important?
Yeah, it's important because when you are smoking your cigars, that leaf help you to your cigars burning equal. If that leaf move from the middle of your cigars, we can get we call it canoa. It's when your cigars burning more in one side than in the another side. That is the important to put that leaf in the middle. So we are ready to roll the long filler. We roll with our hands together, and the long filler is ready. We cut in this machine, and then we put it in this mold. Now I'm going to make a filler with pieces of tobacco leaf, and we call it short filler. In Cuba, we call that picadura. And also in the factories, we make cigars only with whole leaf. Normally, short leaf is made for national smokers. We get one leaf. So we open it here. So now we put all these little pieces of the tobacco leaf in the middle. La picadura. Then we roll, so equal. And we get a char leaf. Char filler, sorry. And we put it in the bowl. So here we have a filler made it with whole leaf, and this filler are made it with the rest of the tobacco leaf.
All right, so we are back. Thank you, William, for showing everybody the difference between short filler and long filler.
Yes, so I think it's good to know. So now when you go into the store, you're going to know how you choose your cigar. You ask, no, I want a long filler. Or if you want to smoke a quick cigar, you grab a short filler. That is your choice.
Cool. I love it. Okay, so let's smoke some cigars also.
That is a good idea. Mm-hmm. And really, we're here to that. To all smoke right. And share our experience with our cigars.
Okay, so William's going to grab our cigars. I think we're going to do a long filler and a short filler. This time, we're going to actually smoke our cigars, but as we move along throughout the weeks, and if you come back week to week, we're actually going to be reviewing and trying other cigars. So if you've got some cigar suggestions that we should try, please definitely comment those suggestions down below. We're thinking about looking at the Cigar Aficionado like top 100 and maybe trying to smoke through those. We're not sure just yet. The other thing is, I am not like the biggest smoker, so you're gonna get from me reviews from like a novice smoker. And one of the things that I think we're gonna do is use this cigar logbook. I'm gonna try to like bring it in just a little for y'all. So this cigar logbook, which is on our website if you'd like one for yourself, but this cigar logbook allows you to kind of log the cigars that you smoke. So this is for 100 cigars. And so maybe we will smoke through 100 cigars. And inside, you get a chance to there's something called like a flavor meter. I don't know if you all can see this, but I'll make sure that we even put maybe some pictures in the description and a link to some pictures in the description box below. So I think I am gonna smoke through some cigars. I'm gonna log them in the book. And that is going to be part of what we do here. So, what did you grab for us?
Yeah, for you, okay. I have a short filler.
Okay, so this is, which cigar is this? Mm-hmm. So, this is our short filler cigar. So, this is our roulette cigar. This has what we learned about is the picaduro inside. So, that is the chopped up leaf of a short filler. What's the wrapper or the capa on this?
The capa we use it in that cigar is a habanero 2000. That wrapper are growing from a Cuba seed, but
in another country. I think it's Costa Rica. Yeah. And what are you smoking?
This is a long filler.
And what's the cigar?
Really, that cigar doesn't need in our store still. We trying a new combination. So what we do is we try the cigar first, and then depend of the quality of the cigars, we put it in our store for you.
Okay, so this is because it's a short filler, it's supposed to burn quicker. I think the other thing about our roulette cigar is that this is the picaduro, or the chopped up tobacco leaf, is from all of the leaves that we use. So I am looking at this like Cigar 100 book to try to guide me through giving you all a review. We're going to see how this goes, friends. I'm going to see. So in terms of the flavor wheel, is it bitter, spicy, earthy, woody, nutty? Let me check it out. Okay. So I would say for me, this feels a little woody. Yeah, it feels a little woody. It's really nice. It's a really smooth smoke. The body on this is mild to me. But I know because this is our roulette and it has, can have like a mix that this happens to be pretty mild in terms of body, but there might be a roulette that's a little bit more medium. Most of them are not going to be full, but there might be something that's a bit more medium. I think the flavor on this is a mild flavor. Hold on.
That is a good flavor. Let me tell you, in my cigars, right now, I'm feeling like it's a little sweet.
Sweet?
Yeah, it's a little sweet in the first.
The first quarter or something.
Yeah. Like that. Yeah. On the beginning is the first time, but actually, so this cigar doesn't is in our store.
I'm gonna figure these out, friends. I'm gonna log this and we're gonna figure it out. Yeah, so if you've got ideas about how that we can better review, especially me, as a novice smoker, please do let me know. I hope you enjoyed this video of ours. We're going to do this weekly. Yep.
Yes. So what time?
Saturdays.
What time at the week on Saturdays? Yeah. Or maybe two times, depends of the situation. Probably we're gonna be live when we are in some places working. We want people know what is the world in Cera Cigar. That is the
It's behind the scenes. So you might get some videos of us preparing for events, packing, who knows, even choosing and deciding different blends and things like that. Yeah, I think that's it. So behind the scenes, this is what it looks like. This is what it looks like to create cigars and how William rolls. And this is us smoking some of our cigars. But we're hoping that you really like the video. Please do subscribe to our channel. You'll see us here every Saturday talking about different topics.
And tell us
what do you want to hear?
Some comments so we can make a better show for you.
And I think
make something fun, educated, and have a good time together.
Yeah, I like it. And just a quick preview for our next show. I think we're going to be talking about a little bit more life in the factory itself. And I think we're going to get into a little bit, folks ask us all the time about like how our brand came about and what Cela means and things like that. So we'll get into that in some of our shows too. And then at some point we'll talk about how me and this guy met, because people always want to know that thing too.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, have a great Saturday, the rest of your Saturday, because this is when we're going to drop it. And we will see you back here next week. Don't forget to subscribe.
Yes.
Bye.